Hello watch fans, it's Anders here on Watch On channel. Today a video which is a little bit different from the usual reviews, unboxings and stuff like that I do here on my channel. This is a video about how you can actually remove some of the worst scratches, the worst hairline scratches on your watches, on your high polish watches. In the video today we have my Rolex DATEJUST 126-300. This is a scratch magnet because, as you can see, we have a lot of polished surfaces. So it's both a smudge and scratch magnet. First of all, we have this plain bezel. You can see, you can sense it, the scratches here. And as you can see, I wear my watches. I'm not super particular about my watches. I don't protect them like it was my child or something like that. They are tools, they are watches, they are meant to be worn. And unless you really beat up your watch, unless you really, really scratch your watch, you can always have them look completely new again. I remember when I bought my Rolex Milgauss, I found a nice full set on Chrono 24, but it was completely beaten up. The crystal was scratched. The bracelet and the high polish case, just like on my DATEJUST here, was completely scratched. And they were not only hairlines, they were kind of deep scratches. So I had it serviced for around $1,000 at the authorized Rolex service center here in Copenhagen. And I must say, the watch, it looked completely new when I got it back. They put in a new crystal and they polished it and of course also cleaned and adjusted the movement. And that actually made it a really good deal, buying a very beat up Rolex for a cheaper price and then having it serviced. So I'm not going to have this serviced. This is my DATEJUST. I bought in August last year, so it's approximately 5 months since I bought it. It was in perfect shape, but now you see all the smudges and the scratches have arrived. And today I want to show you how we can actually remove some of these scratches. If they are deep scratches and if you're in doubt, of course, always take it to the authorized Rolex service center or a trusted watchmaker to have it polished or just have it looked after. So today we're going to use a very popular tool. This is the Cape Cod. This is a nice product for doing some polishing, as you can see here. You actually use Cape Cod and other products like this to remove surface scratches. I have used this on a lot of watches, and if you do it right, you don't do any harm to the watch. You just remove your hairline scratches to make the watch look kind of new again. You have to be very careful with this. Just a disclaimer, don't start to polish your watch every other day, maybe once or twice a year. So let's see what's inside of the box. You of course find a glove, and then you have these polishing cloths, which they look like this. They're kind of, they have some chemicals inside, and then they are able to maybe like very, very finely grained sandpaper, I'm not comparing this to sandpaper, remove scratches. And then you can actually start to work on the scratches. So let's start with actually the bezel. And what you want to do is actually just put on some tape, some very non-chemical, very easy removable tape, just to protect the crystal. So now we have the crystal taped. This is just to protect the crystal. You have to be very, very rough with these Cape Cod cloths, polishing cloths, if you would ever harm the crystal, but just to be completely sure. So what you do is you put on the glove and then you actually just start to polish. You use your hands and then you start to polish all around the bezel here. I'm probably not able to remove all the scratches if they're deep. I have one scratch, as you saw before, which is kind of deep, but I can definitely make this watch look a lot better. I have done this for several years on several different watches, and it never really failed me. But just again, be careful. Don't start to try to do a lot of things with scratches if they're not kind of surface scratches or hairlines. Take it to the watchmaker or your dealer. So now I'm finished with the bezel. Let's take the sides of the case. They are much easier than a bezel. Now I'm going to just do a light polishing on the center links, because they are also high polished, and then I'm going to end with the clasp. Then we're going to clean the watch in water and see the result. So now I'm done with all the polishing. As you saw during the video, I did fast forward. I would say if you're going to give your watch a complete polish, don't polish any less than 15 to 20 minutes. Be very patient, it takes some time. What we're going to do now is remove the tape and clean the watch. Remember, if you're going to clean your watch in water, don't forget to actually be checking that it's water resistant, and if you have it on a leather strap, of course remove the leather strap. This is a DATEJUST from Rolex. It has a screw down crown and it's also water resistant to 100 meters, so you can easily clean it under water. If you can't clean it under water, maybe use a wet cloth to clean it very carefully, just to not destroy the watch because of very lesser water resistance. And just before we clean, here you can see the cloth. It was completely new before I started. What I found is that you can easily just keep the cloth, put it back in the protection, because you still have some parts of the cloth you can use, but be sure to seal the protection to not have it dry out. So now the watch is polished and it's also cleaned in water, but you want to do some more cleaning. You just take some regular soft kitchen paper or toilet paper or whatever you have, very soft. And you can see you get some dirt and some of the case, some of the polishing. So you see here, I got some of the excess metal off. Then I continue with a fiber cloth just to have the perfect polishing, and then we're going to look at the results. So that's it for now. Let's have a look. You see it looks much, much better. You see this scratch has become much less pronounced, but it will probably need a professional polishing to remove completely. I'm very happy with the result. It looks much, much better. I'm not wearing gloves now, so all the smudges from my fingers, from my finger oil, is going to get onto the watch. Let's have a look at the clasp. That's much, much better. You get some of the worst scratches, but again, if you really want to have an immaculate looking high polished watch, then you will definitely need to take it to a professional polishing at the watchmaker. So I will be following up this video with a 6-month review in 1 month time to give you the opinion of owning the Rolex DATEJUST 41 for 6 months, the pluses and the minuses. I hope you enjoyed this do-it-yourself video. Please don't send any death threats, all you angry engineers. I'm just kidding. And if you enjoyed it, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, follow me on Instagram and Facebook, leave a comment down below and give this video a thumbs up. Me and my DATEJUST and Cape Cod are saying goodbye. See you next time. Bye.